Hi, welcome to the spoken tutorial series on the Orcast Print Reader. I am Krishnakant Mane from the spoken tutorial team at IIT Mumbai. I am a totally blind person and absolutely depend on this amazing software. Orca is a powerful state-of-the-art FOSS-based screen reader for the GNU/Linux operating system. With the help of this assistive software, a totally blind person can perform all the desktop activities without sighted assistance. In this series, we will start from the initial setup of Orca and then move on to do some advanced personal and professional activities. So, let's get started. In my case, I am using the Linux version 3 of the GNU/Linux operating system, because one gets the initial feedback when you are using this distro. But you can use other distros such as Ubuntu, Fedora, etc. Also note that if you are using the Linux distro of GNU/Linux, then you might not require to follow the instructions in this tutorial, because Orca is already configured and set up for you. Assuming that you have entered the username and the password, you will now be on the desktop. So let's start setting up Orca. Press Alt plus F2 to get to the run dialog. This is the place where you would enter the commands to be executed immediately. Here, type Orca and press Enter.
Welcome to Orca setup. Select the Lion Speech server. 1. Default synthesizer. 2. DeepSpeak. 3. Dummy. Enter choice.
So now you can hear Orca asking us a few questions. The first question is about selecting the speech synthesizer. Enter 2 for eSpeak speech synthesizer, after which Orca will ask us for the language selection.
Select the Lion voice. 1. DeepSpeak default voice N. 3. Afrikaans F. 3. Bosnian Buzzer. 4. Catalan K. Get Z. Fares. Crash Wells Test Q. 2. Venice Fair. 8. German D. Enea Greek L. 10. Default N. 11. N. Scottish N. 12. English N. 13. Lancashire N. 14. English underscore R P N. 15. English underscore W meets N. 16. English and N. 17. In West Indies in Bacock Esperanto Air, yet in Web Expandis S, Main Expandis Latin American S, Capsicum and Palsy in this key, Master French FN, Master French Belgium, 24 Drake Alpha New C Alpha Epsilon New Tau Camerosi, put this in the test high.
As you will notice, Orca has a lot of languages from which you can choose. There are more languages getting added with every version of Orca. So, enter 12 for English voice.
Enable echo by word. Enter by RN.
Now, Orca is asking us if we want to hear back every word as it is typed. We will answer yes for this question. For this, enter the character Y.
Enable key echo, enter Y or N.
Now Orca asks us if we want to hear every key as we press it. We will answer yes for this question.
Enable alphanumeric and punctuation keys, enter Y or N.
Now Orca is asking us if we want to have Orca echo every alphanumeric and punctuation key, which means every character including punctuation. So, if we enter yes for this question, we will exactly hear that. So let's press Y.
Enable modifier keys. Enter Y or N.
Orca now asks us if we also want to hear the keys including Shift, Alt and Control keys to be echoed back. Let's enter Y as in yes.
Enable login keys. Enter Y or N.
This is a similar option. In this case, Orca is asking us if we want to hear the caps lock numlock and the scroll lock key being echoed. Let's enter yes for this as well.
Enable function keys. Enter Y or N.
Now Orca asks us a similar question again. This time it's about echoing the function keys. Let's press Y as in yes.
Enable action keys. Enter Y or N.
The action keys are escape and enter. So answering yes for this question will tell Orca that we want to hear the keys escape and enter being echoed. So let's enter yes.
Select desired keyboard layout. 1. Desktop. 2. Laptop. Enter choice.
Now we have come to a very important option. Orca is asking us to choose a keyboard layout. There are two layouts from which we have to choose. First, there is a desktop layout and then there is a laptop layout. The reason for having two different layouts is that a laptop keyboard does not have a numeric keypad, while a desktop has a numeric keypad to the right of the arrow keys. Since many Orca navigation keys are associated with the numeric keypad, they have to be adjusted for a laptop. So enter 1 for selecting the desktop layout or enter 2 for laptop layout. I am going to enter 1 for the desktop layout.
Enable Braille. Enter Y or N.
Now Orca is asking us if we wish to enable Braille. Since these tutorials are concerned with text-to-speech audio output, Braille is not within the scope of this tutorials. So I will enter no as in N.
Enable Braille monitor. Enter Y or N.
This option is also related to Braille. A Braille monitor is a place where a visually disabled person can put the hand and see the embossed dots. Since we are not using a Braille monitor, we will type N and enter as in no.
Automatically start Orca when you log in. Enter Y or N.
Well, now Orca asks if it should start automatically when you log in. You might be tempted to answer yes, but it's highly recommended to answer this no for two reasons. Firstly, if you keep Orca running at startup, it consumes a lot of memory at the startup and might slow down your system. The second reason is that if a sighted person is also going to use the same machine, he might perhaps be irritated to hear the initial Orca output. So we'll enter no for this.
Accessibility support for Node has just been enabled. You need to log out and log back in for the change to take effect. Do you want to log out now? Enter Y or N.
Hey, and can you hear this? Orca tells us that the accessibility setup is complete, which means Orca is ready for work. But we need to log out and log back in again to the same user account to start using Orca. So we will answer yes for this question as in type Y and press enter.
Setup complete. Logging out now.
You're logging out now. As you heard, the machine gave a bang, which means we are at the login prompt. So we'll have to again enter the username and password, which I'll just do. So we have logged back into the machine where we have set up Orca, and now let's start Orca itself. What I'm going to do is I'll press Alt plus F2 and enter Orca. So here we go. Alt plus F2 and O R C A enter.
Welcome to Orca Screen Reader / Magnifier Frame. Preferences button.
As we can hear, Orca is started, it's running and we can start using it. When you are on the desktop, the most fundamental thing is a menu. So just to give you a feel of how Orca responds, I am going to open the applications menu, which actually contains all the applications. So I'll press Alt plus F1.
Right. Top expanded edge panel frame, applications menu.
Okay, so here we go. We are in the applications menu and we can press the up and down arrows to actually see what's around. So let's press the down arrow.
Accessories menu.
It says accessories menu. You can press down again.
Games menu.
So press down arrow again.
Graphics menu.
Again the down arrow.
Internet menu.
Again down.
Office menu.
So you can see that there are a lot of categories in the menu, such as internet, office, games, accessories, etc. So you can open any of these menus and see what's there inside. So let's go up till we locate the accessories menu. So I'll keep pressing up arrow, and every time I press the up arrow, you would hear the change focus.
Internet menu, graphics menu, games menu, accessories menu.
So let's open this submenu called accessories by pressing the right arrow.
Calculator.
So the first option here is calculator.
CD/DVD creator.
We have a CD/DVD creator.
Character map.
There's a character map which is used for calligraphical activities.
Disk usage analyzer.
There's a disk usage analyzer.
Debit text editor.
And there is a text editor called gedit. So we are going to open the gedit text editor now. So let's press enter on this option to actually open the text editor.
Return. Orca screen reader / magnifier frame. Preferences button. Applications menu menu. Unsaved document 1 debit frame. Unsaved document 1 page text.
So Orca gives us a lot of information. It says that the gedit text editor is open with an unsaved document which is named as unsaved document 1. So you can type in this text editor and save the file, but that will be for a later tutorial. So did you enjoy setting up Orca? In the next tutorial, we will see how to do more adjustments to Orca, including the speed at which it speaks, the pitch, volume, and many other basic configurations. So until then, this is Krishnikant Mani signing off. Goodbye and have fun.